she said it. I said, I didn't even see holes, and she went on, but I can't get over my baby. I don't know why God's taking my baby. Why would he do it? All right. In a year, 6 months' time, he even preaches to that. I lost my father, my brother, my wife, and my baby. And just a little bit, just right straight, 1, 2, 3. And this was the last of it all. My daddy died in my arms. And my brother was killed on a telephone pole right over from it. But that night I came home and I told mother, she was all broke up too. Daddy just recently went. And so I went over home then to go in. I tried to pass. My mother wanted me to stay in her house. And my mother-in-law wanted me to come down there. But if you ever have a home of your own, there's no place satisfied anymore. I went over there. I tried to pass. My head was cold. And I had this one little stove out in the kitchen. A room out there, and frost and snow was coming up through the floor. And I go in there tonight and try to cook. Just an old cot laying there. And I went in that night. I'll never forget. I went around the corner. I picked up the paper and the mail in the box and went in the house. We didn't have any furniture, but they wanted me to get rid of it. But friend, it wasn't very much. But what it was, it belonged to her and I. We had it together. No matter how poor it was. It was ours. I didn't want to get rid of it. We had lived together. She'd taken care of it. I seen her clothes hanging up behind the door. I just couldn't forget it. And I got my mail, went around a 7-year-old cold room I've been working. First one opened up and said, Miss Sherry Rose Brand. Little 8-inch Christmas saying it sent back to me. Oh my, that was all over again. I just couldn't stand it. Like I couldn't go any farther. I knelt down and started crying and praying. I went in the next room. We got out of the box and pulled out my revolver, 38 revolver, got 6 shells in it. I've been hunting. Come back in the room. I said, God, I'm going insane. I don't want to bring reproach. I'm going insane. I'd rather commit suicide than to go insane, so I'm going to meet you now. Father, you forgive me for the sin. I can't stand any longer. You're not consoling my heart. I can't stand any longer. And I pulled back the hammer. I put it upside my head. I knelt down there with that old dirty cot. I said, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I'm going to squeeze on the trigger. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. I squeezed with all my might, and the hammer wouldn't fall. And I said, oh, I can't even take my own life. I threw the gun, it went off. Bullet went out through the house, my thing. Oh, God, what can I do? I was dying. It was like, I threw my head over on the bed. I went off to sleep. Just a few moments to closing. I went off to sleep. And I dreamed that I was back out west again. I thought I was kind of walking down the prairie and I was whistling a song. The wheel on the wagon is broken. You heard the song. I looked and there was an old prairie schooner and the wheels broke down. And I thought, well, what do you know? I looked standing there next to a beautiful blonde-headed girl, long blonde hair hanging down, dressed in snowy white. I had a great big hat. I took it off. I said, how do you do, miss? And started walking over. She said, hello, Dad. I looked around and I said, Dad? I said, yes. And I said, why, a lady, you're as old as I am. How could you have your daddy? She said, well, Daddy, don't you remember? You teach immortality. I don't teach to be little bitty babies in heaven. I teach immortality. You don't get old. Just a little baby when it gets there to be a little baby forever. Immortality don't decay. And she said, don't you remember you're teaching me immortality? She said, down on earth, I was your little Sharon Rose. I said, honey, you're not Sharon. She said, yes. She said, where's Billy Paul? That's your little brother. I said, oh, I left him. Honey, I don't understand it. She said, Daddy, you just don't know where you're at. And I said, well, I'm not on the prairie. She said, no, turn here, right, and look. And I looked back, and there was a great, beautiful light coming up in the most beautiful place I ever seen. She said, this is heaven, Daddy. She said, Mother's up there at home waiting for you. And I said, home? You mean I got a home? I said, honey, there never was a greater generation ever had a home of their own. I said, you mean that I got a home? She said, but Daddy, you got one now. That's the reason, even if I am living in a two-room shack, I'd rather live in that two-room shack and have favor with God than the best home you've got in the land here. And I said, well, honey, that ain't my home. She said, yes, it is. Mother's looking for you. I started walking up towards it. singing that song, My Home, and I thought the lights would turn up around, great, beautiful palace. I walked up the steps, and I looked coming, walking down the ladder, and there she comes. Snowy white clothes on her, black hair dripping down around her shoulders, her dark eyes looked like the splendor of youth. She died at 22 years old. She comes walking down to meet me. She held out her arm. I ran to her real quick and bowed down my head. I said, oh, honey, I don't understand. She said, did you meet Sharon? I said, uh-huh. I said, isn't she a pretty girl? Isn't our little honey make a pretty girl? I said, she sure is. I said, where's Billy? I said, honey, wait just a minute. I said, there's something wrong here. Just as natural as standing here. I said, there's something wrong. I said, she said, Bill. So you're so tired, aren't you? I said, yes. So you've been praying for the sick. And I hadn't prayed for the sick in them days. So that's the reason I know sometimes I pass out here in pulpit praying. The other night when I was with you, I passed completely out of one night. I passed out for as many as 24 hours at a time. And I know one of these nights, I'm going. That's true. I used to wear 158 pounds, I weigh 120 something now. I used to wear a 38 coat, here at 24. I'm going. It's true. But I want to be faithful, not do them things again that I did do. She said, you're tired, you've been praying for the sick. I said, that's right. She said, don't cry now. She used to console me, and I think things would go all right. I'd come home and cry about it. She'd put her arms around me, go to pat me. She'd say, don't cry. She said, stand up. And I raised up. She said, won't you sit down? I looked over there, and there was a great big three chair sitting there. I looked at that chair. I looked back at her. She said, I don't know what you're thinking of. Down on earth. One time, I went and bought a chair. I was just so tired working and preach half the night and make all her calls and things. And I bought a chair that cost $15.95. I paid $2 out on it. I could pay $1.25 a month, I believe it was, on it. And I, you know, friends, all of you know, how you get, you know, tight places. And I missed 2 or 3 months' payments, and I couldn't pay my $1.25. And that's the only good piece of furniture we had in the house. And I used to like to go there and sit down in this chair, rest at night, maybe 12 on the clock, rest a little while, maybe read my Bible. And I got there high, and I couldn't make them. They sent me a notice that said, come and get the chair. And I remember how she dreaded getting that notice. She was a real girl. And she's gone. But I love her just the same. That's right. And she said, I hate that to say something to you, honey. We didn't have nothing else. We could settle and make the payment. I said, sweetheart, I don't care about the chair. Just let it go. Finally, she kept it as long as she could. Finally, she had to come get it. And I remember the day when they come and got it. That night, she had me a cherry pie cooked. It was always like cherry pie. So, well, she was trying to make me, you know, and she had the boys that did some fishing worms and she went, I know there's something wrong. So after supper was over, we went into the room. I said, let's go in. She said, oh, let's go fishing. She didn't even see the chair down. So then when I said, let's go in the room, I put my arm around and walked in the room. When I walked in, then the chair being gone, she leaned her head over me and commenced to cry. I said, that's all right. She said to me then, I said, you remember that chair that they had to come? I said, yes. I said, yes. She said, it's my son, let me come get that. It's paid for. Oh, friend, look. I guess you think I'm a baby, but look. Someone said that they said, Brother Rand, when you ever get any rest? I got to face the rest. One of these days, we'll cross over on the other side. I got a chair there to sit down in. It's about your time, I... Oh, forgive me. Oh, God, have mercy. As my mind goes back to those days, thank the day that her grave is covered with snow, my precious darling baby lay there. I'm thinking of Easter morning how her little boy, Billy, and I kneel over the side of the grave, poor dead, placed in flower. I promise you, God, I promise you, you forgive me, I do all that I can do for you. Help me, won't you, God? So hard for the people to see, Father, and believe. Won't you help me now? Thou knowest that I want to be a baby before these people, but, oh, God, home. Rest your precious soul. Rest the soul of my baby. God, let me be the father, the husband, the child of yours that you want me to be. Dear God, this afternoon while we're here, if there is some here who doesn't know you, I pray that you'll forgive them also, Father. For we ask it in his name. Excuse me, friends. I just can't go on with it, but I'm tired and weary today. I got dropping clean after service tonight. Maybe the last one ever getting. But there waits for me a glass of oil, where gates of pearls swing open wide. When I cross this veil of sorrow on a camp up on the other side. Don't you want to go over too? How many of you here today would like to meet me over at the other side? Is there a promise? Is there an appointment? I wonder, from the depth of my heart, I've heard some do this, but I feel to do this. I wonder if there's an unsaved person here now. So just say, stand up and say, Brother Branham, pray for me now. If God here, God bless you, brother. Somebody else, God bless you, sister. You, stand up, that's right. All you that have not received the Holy Spirit, stand on your feet. Say, pray for me, Brother Branham. That's right, God bless you. Look at the awe in your soul. Just stay, remain standing at the moment. Just remain, every one of you. Unsaved. Home mercy. There's a land beyond the river, just remain standing. There's a place that we meet again. Some 50, 75 people now. I wonder to hear, if God hears my prayer to open the eyes of the blind, to heal the deaf and the dumb, don't you think He'll hear my prayer to pray for you? Don't you think He will? All right. How many more in here would like to be joined in this prayer? Just raise up. How many here that's right? I'm saved. Raise up. While the piano plays, I wonder if you just grab up here and shake your hand at the altar. Let me shake your hand, stand here. Let's pray together. God wants to save you. Come here, let me shake your hand while the music is playing.
God bless you, sister. God bless you, sister.
Just remain right here where you're at the altar.
God bless you, sister. God bless you, sister. God bless you. God bless you, sister. You. God bless you, sweetheart, children. God bless your little heart. God bless you. That's right. God bless you. God bless you, brother. God bless you and you, each one of you. God bless you. God bless you, sister. God bless you, my dear brother. God bless you.
Oh, my, won't you come look together here on the altar? Won't you come to unsaved?